So, just had another thought. What conversation about health and safety could fail to include safe lifting of things? Obviously, it's very easy to hurt yourself trying to pick up heavy things. Nowadays, I'm very pleased to say there's a move away from just having macho strong people to carry everything, and there's quite sensible guidelines as to what sort of weight a normal person should be able to lift. It's kilos, probably about 25 kilos, something like that. Can't remember exact, but makes sense. Easy way to think of it, 25 kilos, that's like, if you had a cake, fruit cake probably, not a sponge or something, because they don't weigh much, but a good solid fruit cake probably weighs half a kilo. So that's, you'd be okay with up to about 50 fruit cakes. What you'd probably want to do is make some sort of a yoke and then have a tray either side, so you could carry 25 each side and you could run fairly quickly if you needed to. But more typically in the theatre, you might end up having to lift other stuff. Now, I've got two really hot tips for this. The first one is a forklift truck. Forklift, brilliant idea. I can't fault it. I was lucky enough to be working on something called the Big Cheese Tour, which was the launch all over Europe of the film Ratatouille when it came out. And someone's brilliant idea for that film launch was to have a massive piece of cheese built out of a truss big enough to house a cinema. So this massive piece of cheese shaped truss then covered in stuff you get on the side of lorries, only made to look like cheese. So it looked like a huge piece of cheese. And in one of the holes, it's sort of Leerdammer or something like that, a cheese that had holes in. You went in through one of the holes and you sat on a fiberglass piece of cheese and watched the screen and saw the film, Ratatouille. There you go. Anyway, my job was to go out and run the crew taking down the piece of cheese overnight before it then went off to the next venue. And my friend Wazza ran the fit up, putting the cheese back together again. So what I do recall on one of these events, obviously they're outdoors, and one place we did it, I can't remember, it might have been Frankfurt, I haven't a clue, somewhere in Europe anyway, we had to do it on some soft, well, next to some soft ground, otherwise there's a field. A load of plastic flooring had been put down. It's this sort of click together, it's a bit like a jigsaw flooring being put down so we could walk about on it without making the field muddy. Unfortunately, the forklift truck lifted something up and sank through it. So, which is where, and this is the important bit, if you've got a forklift on site, have two, because you'll need one to lift the other one out when it goes through the floor and sinks into the mud. Hot tip. My second hot tip, I found myself a number of years ago in Helsinki doing, we were doing what could only be described as a stadium tour of Grease, the musical. I don't know why, it baffles me. I was on holiday from Brit and it seemed like a good thing. Anyway, I know it was Helsinki because we ended up doing a lot of tobogganing there down the mountain where they'd run the Winter Olympics years before. You could go up, hire a toboggan and slide down the mountain. It's brilliant. We got addicted to it. Unfortunately, we only had just our theatre rigging clothes, so I had my steel toe cap boots and my blacks and a coat and some rigging gloves, so that's what I wore. And we went down the mountain. We got addicted to it. We ended up going down in the dark with torches in our mouths, and then we ended up going off-piste because actually going down the proper toboggan run got a bit stayed after a few runs. So I do remember going down in the dark with a mag light in my mouth straight through the forest on this bobsleigh, a sledge. It wasn't a bobsleigh, different thing altogether, sledge. On my own, it was great. Anyway, the point is, while we were there doing the fit-up, it was a big fit-up, it was a stadium, it was an ice hockey stadium. They had to lay a floor all over the ice and then they had to put the stage on top of that, and it was all big, loads of lorries. I was delighted to be introduced when I got there to this enormous man, he was introduced to me as Guy, the man who is here to help you. That was me slipping into a Helsinkian accent. What do you call someone from Helsinki? I don't know. Brummies come from Birmingham. Scousers come from Liverpool. Who comes from Helsinki? Not a clue. Anyway, nice bloke. Massive, huge, muscly man called Guy. And so all I had to do if I wanted to lift anything up was say, Guy, do you mind terribly? Could you just lift that up for me, please? And he would go, yes, of course. And lift up whatever it was. As I didn't test him to destruction, but to my certain knowledge, he could lift up like 80 kilos and wander about with it. So that was good. So that's my hot tip: either forklift or big muscly bloke from Helsinki. There you go.